Hello, my name is Oren. I'm 8 years old and I do the laundry in my house. So I'm gonna teach you how to do the laundry. To do the laundry, you need the basket and the laundry. You need soap and dryer sheets. And you also need a little bit of money. For some places, you can use a credit card, these little tickets, or some quarters. Most people like to sort their laundry into lights and darks. So you can put it all in as one load, but your clothes might not last as long and might not look as good. Light, dark. The washer is a part that makes people think that they can't do it. So the cool thing that they do is they tell you right there, and you're in college, you should know how to read. Pretty much all your clothes can be washed on permanent press. So the first thing you do is you take your ticket and or your quarters or whatever you have, and you push it in and it turns on the water. And then you take your soap and you pour it in. You take your clothes and you put them in too. And then you close them. While you're waiting, you should probably do your homework because you're in college. When your clothes are done, you need a dryer. And on the dryer, there are also instructions. When your clothes are done in the washer, put them in the dryer, get a dryer sheet, and put it in too. Then you close the door. Put in the quarters and press start. Now, when you're finished in the dryer, you can take them out. You can either fold them at the laundromat or you can take them back to your room. You should probably fold them there because if you stuff them in the drawer, they're going to be too wrinkly.
When we start learning how to do wash, the first thing we do is sort. We're gonna sort our colors with our colors and our whites with our whites because we don't wanna mix our whites with our colors or else you'll end up with like pink underwear or something like that.
Okay.
Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is sort. So let's get started.
Okay. If this sock has red on it, do I put it in the...
Okay, this is a good question. We've got a dirty red and white sock here. In this case, this sock has been washed a million times already, so we don't need to worry about the red bleeding through. So I would go ahead and call this a white because it's mostly white. Stinky. White pile. Okay. Continue sorting.
As you can see, we've now sorted our laundry. We have our colored pile and we have our white pile. Go ahead and load the laundry into the washer. Now you might have a lot more laundry than you have space. So hold on, nothing's gonna get clean that way.
Okay, you're gonna have to break this up into probably three loads. Okay, and when you load, you have to make sure that it's not all crumpled up into a big ball into the washer, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so you want these things stretched out as much as possible, okay?
So they can fit around there?
So they can fit around there and not get stuck and stay dirty, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so this is actually a pretty decent load size. Okay, so we've loaded it up. We don't want it too high because we want it to get clean. And now we're going to add soap. This is Gain laundry detergent. I am in no way sponsored by Gain for this post. It just happens to be what I have because it was on sale. Okay, now, see the lines inside this cup? There's a 1, a 2, and a 3. Okay, 1 is for a small load, 2 is for a medium, 3 is for a large. So what will we use for this?
A 2.
It's not medium. It's filled to the top.
Oh. 3.
Okay. So we're going to pour it up to the line number 3, and dump it in.
Here?
In here.
Oh, okay.
Straight on the clothes. Now, you guys, I realize that there are rules about when to load laundry detergent and you're supposed to wait till there's water and stuff like that. I've been doing laundry this way for 100 years, and for the sake of teaching my tween, I'm gonna keep this as simple as possible. So, from my experience, it's A-okay to dump laundry soap right on your load, so that's what we're gonna go ahead and do here. Close the lid. Now, we have to set our load size. Small, medium, large, or super plus?
Large.
Large? I think this is super plus. It's pretty full.
Okay.
This affects how much water you'll get in the washer when you wash. Wash temperature. Now, this is a mix of colors. So what color? What temperature do we wash on?
Warm?
No. With colors, we're going to stick with cold.
Oh.
Okay? So we're going to stick with cold. Don't worry about the extra rinse. For the purposes of this and the clothes that you're going to be washing, we're just going to go with normal wash, regular. You pull the handle to start it. Go ahead and pull. Friend, you started your first load of laundry. All right, good job.
Okay, now that the wash is done, what do we have to do now with the clothes?
Time to dry the clothes.
Time to dry the clothes. Okay, and how do we go about doing that?
Load the clothes from the washer into the dryer.
Okay, so first thing you have to do, open the dryer. Go ahead, open the wash and load all the clothes from the wash into the dryer. Okay, before you close the dryer, you got everything?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you need to add a dryer sheet. This is what keeps your clothes from being all staticky and it keeps your clothes soft. So add one. Okay, throw it in. Close the dryer. Now, you're gonna set the timer. Set it for about 45 minutes. Okay? And for the purposes of your clothes, because they're all cotton and, you know, nothing delicate, I don't want you to worry about touching the temperature. There's nothing special you need to do. You need to clean the lint trap. Because if you don't do that, the lint trap. Okay? You need to clean it. Do you know how to do that?
Just grab the lint.
Just grab what you can, okay? It's just lint, it's not gross, okay? Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Put the lint trap back, can you do that? And press start. Yep, right here. All right, good job, now your clothes are drying.
I'm gonna teach you guys how to do laundry because I feel everyone should know how to do their own laundry. And I've heard a lot of stories of people going off to college and they don't know how to do their own laundry and then they just smell. So it's extremely simple. I learned it when I was like 10, 11. If a child can do it, you can do it. It's super simple, and so let's get into it, shall we? We're gonna wash my clothes together. Here's my laundry. I took out all the underwear and bras because I knew someone out there would try and screenshot all of them. So you don't have to worry about it anymore. Let's dump it out and learn how to wash it. Fantastic. Have you ever noticed that there are tags on your clothes? Those tags usually tell you how to wash the article of clothing. But if you're like me, you cut the tags off. But before you do, you should at least glance at it to make sure there's not some crazy warning on it, like don't wash it ever or don't dry clean it ever. But anyway, you basically glance at it, see if it says you should wash it in warm, cold, line dry, tumble dry, don't iron, do iron. They all give instructions on how to wash. Like this Hanes shirt. Don't use fabric softener. Okay, cool. And it says I can wash it in warm water and dry it and iron it. So it's letting me know this can be washed in a normal manner. So basically what you do is you separate them. Now, there are multiple different ways you can separate clothing. You can go light colors and dark colors. You can go cold water, warm water. I like to separate cold water, warm water. And then if the pile is big enough, separate my lights from my darks. So let's separate. Cold, so light colors, cold water. This one is dark cold, dark colors, cold water, and this is warm, dark. Also, I don't care. Like, white socks, I don't care if these change color at all, so it doesn't matter. You know, like, a lot of comedy shows goof about, oh no, you put a red sock in the wash with all my white shirts, now everything's pink! Yeah, that's actually happened to me before. So, it wasn't my red sock! Someone put it in my whites, and everything turned pink. Dark colors sometimes bleed, and that will change the colors of your lights. That's why you separate them. So, cold water, you're less likely to shrink your clothes in cold water. Hot water will shrink them a little bit, but it kills more bacteria. So that's why I usually do all my socks, my jeans, my sweatpants in warm, because I don't care if they shrink a little bit. Also, they're probably the ones that need the most bacteria killed. Okay, so you've separated them. Make sure as you're separating that you check the pockets of everything to make sure there's no paper, money, pens. In the last place I lived, someone always left a pen in the dryer, like a writing utensil. I have sheets that have blue pen mark all over them because I dried them in that dryer and the pen was still in there and destroyed my sheets. I still use them though. So you check all your pockets, make sure there's nothing in there. Gum. Oh! I had a piece of plastic. So we've read the tags. We've sorted them into piles. We've checked the pockets. Now it's time to wash them. Now, every washer is different. Every dryer is different. Well, not like every, they're not all snowflakes. They make multiple of the same washer and dryer, but it's rare that you will come encounter with the exact same washing machine your entire life. And they'll all seem scary. Every new washer seems scary because you don't know how to work it, but it's very simple. There's usually a knob for the temperature, what temperature you want it at, and how intense you want it to wash it. There's normal, which people usually use for towels, and there's delicates. People usually use that for their lights and their panties and things like that. Basically, it's like, do you want me to wring this to death and pound it and get every ounce of dirt out, or do you just want to clean? All right, let's go wash this. Welcome to my washer. Okay, so what I didn't mention just now, but I should, if you have any heavy stains on your shirt that you need to pre-treat before you put it in the washer, now's the time to do it. Spray some Shout on it, do your grandma's secret recipe on your shirt, whatever you need to do to get out the stain, do that now. Okay?
However, if you want to make sure the stain comes out, treat it as soon as possible. The more time the stain has to dry, the less likely it is to come out.
Okay, now it's time to load it up. Ding, 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 ding. Push it all in. It's in. Close the door. Now it depends on what kind of washer you're using. Some washers, you have to put the detergent in before. Some you have to put it in after. It depends on your washer. But mine, you put the clothes in and then you put the detergent in this little drawer. So detergents usually come with a little cup to let you know how much you're supposed to put in and then that's how much you do it. So how big your load is depends on how much detergent you put in. Makes sense, right? Okay, so I put the detergent in the little slot, normal. I'm not putting any fabric softener in because I don't need it. But I'm gonna do power, and then these are my delicate clothes, and I'm putting it on cold water. I want the spin medium cycle, and then I hold start, and they shall be washed. And then in 37 minutes, I will dry them. So I will see you, okay, that's loud. I'll see you in 37 minutes. All right, so the washer went off, and now you open up the washer. You can't see it, but that's very self-explanatory. And you take everything out of the washer and put it into the dryer. Okay, now before you start the dryer, you have to check the lint trap. It's different in, oh wow, that is full. This stuff comes off of your clothes and it gets caught in this, which is what it's supposed to do. It's a lint catcher. It's different in every dryer, but make sure that's cleaned out before you start the dryer so it doesn't ruin everything. I like to put a little dryer sheet, a little bounce sheet, if you will, in the dryer so that there's less static and it smells nice. And it makes things feel softer. Close that baby up, then you turn your dryer on and figure out how hot you want it. I personally would like it delicate, so it's on a low heat temperature so that it does not shrink my clothing. Start! And that will be going for about 30 minutes, so I'll see you guys in 30 minutes! Okay, so the dryer's done, it went off. Open it, and then you check to see if things are actually dry, because dryers like to lie to you and say things are dry when they're not. It's dry. And then you just put it all back in your basket. No, no. I'm missing the basket! I keep missing! I make it seem more difficult than it actually is. All right, and then always check to make sure nothing got left behind. Nope, all clear. And then you take it to another location and fold it. But close that, or else the light will eventually burn out inside of it and your mom will get mad at you. It's happened to me. Now you just fold them and put them away. I hope you guys know how to fold clothes. That could be a whole other video.